If you love Baltimore sports, you'll love WNST.net.
Right now, go for it.
Hey, this is Andy Sussman. How's everyone doing today? I talked a little bit about it here on the air, about Buck Showalter and what he's done for the Orioles and what needs to be done. You know, we had Dave Tremblay in the beginning of the year, and obviously the Orioles didn't do anything with him. And then he was fired. Juan Samuel was the interim manager. I saw the first game that he managed when the Orioles lost to the Red Sox 10-0. It might have been the worst I've ever seen the Orioles play. So clearly there was nothing positive to come of that, and we didn't play any better down the stretch for Juan Samuel. You know, I don't think Juan Samuel's a bad manager. You know, I just think this team was totally unmotivated, as it was. You know, I mean, we were clearly underachieving, and there really just didn't seem to be much hope. Then finally, after about 2, maybe even 3 months of rumors that Buck Showalter was going to be the manager of the Orioles, he officially was announced manager of the Orioles on August 3rd. And the first game he managed, we won. The second game he managed, we won. We won the first 4 games with him, and we've gone 10-5 with him at the helm for the Orioles. Now, is this legitimate? And that, I think that's a valid question to ask. You know, how legitimate is any manager, really? I mean, clearly a bad manager can mess up a team, but can a really good manager seriously have that drastic of a change from the worst team in baseball to a team that now even, you know, many Baltimore people who have been extremely pessimistic are starting to look up about the team, you know, whether it's for the end of this year or for next year? Now, I don't know how much of what Buck Showalter has done has been imagined, but you know what? Honestly, to a point, it doesn't really matter. Because, let's face it, like every sport, a lot of baseball is mental. And if, whether it was due to Buck Showalter or not, and honestly, how much could Buck Showalter really do? You know, he's been putting out the same lineup as, you know, the same. He has the same guys. He doesn't have the luxury of just picking whoever he wants, really. And he came into this organization fresh. But the fact that we've started winning, the fact that players seem to believe, at least to an extent, that this could be different, I think, honestly, is a big step, because a lot of the game is mental. And if the players have the confidence to excel under Buck Showalter. Look, the majority of them are playing for their jobs next year. And honestly, it wouldn't surprise me one bit if Buck Showalter told everyone, look, you know what, pretty much you have no chance at making the roster if you don't play well next year, so you better play your ass off. It wouldn't surprise me. Honestly, it wouldn't, because that's what needs to happen. You know, I heard Nestor talking earlier about Adam Jones tweeting he's bored. You know, things like that, it's just not acceptable, you know, in a workplace. And baseball is a workplace, and it's a workplace where everyone's making a lot of money, and there's a whole lot of demand to win. I mean, managers get fired all the time, and Buck Showalter will be damn sure he's not going to lose his job because some player tweets that he's bored and they don't play their hardest. So I think that if Buck Showalter can, you know, light a fire under these guys' butts, that this team really could potentially turn around. Now, when I say turn around, I'm being relative here, because we're in the AL East, the Orioles. I'm realistic about this team. All right, we've been below 500 since 1997, and I don't think all of a sudden we're going to be a playoff team with the Yankees, Rays, and Red Sox involved, and not to mention the Blue Jays, who are also above 500. So, you know, I think when it comes down to it, if we can have a positive attitude going forward, that it could make a difference, but clearly nothing's going to be immediate, even if something does happen. And, you know, obviously the Oriole fan of me hopes so, but I have to also be pragmatic about it and wonder, you know, how long will this last? You know, what if when we undergo our first slump with Showalter, which, you know, is going to happen with everybody, it happens. You know, will we stop? Will everybody stop believing, the fans, the players, everyone like that? So, yeah, I just wanted to talk some about Buck Showalter, the Orioles. I'm Andy Sussman. Keep sports in your mind. Nestor, you want to?
Back to me. What's going on, man? You all right?
If you love Baltimore sports, you'll love WNST.net.